paper that I took at Pace was reacting to the past on Zoom, which is very interesting to do an acting out history class on Zoom. But surprisingly enough, I had a blast. Like, absolutely just what Caroline was saying. I don't like history. Sorry, Bill. And it just really turned it around for me. It was so interesting, and that's probably my favorite thing about honors courses, is that you're not going to come into a room like this and sit and listen to people talk at you for hours on end and just suffer. You get to do fun things while you're learning the same content. And that's one of the most amazing things about honors courses, because the 8 courses may sound a little daunting when you don't know yet, but once you start taking them, it's like, oh my gosh, this is so much fun. And it's the same with advising. I mean, these people surrounding this room get us through this, literally, because without the support of our advisors, we would be lost. And although everything is up to us and it's a partnership, they do a lot. And one of the most amazing things about honors through my years here is the individualization of the advising that we receive. In a mainstream setting, you're like one number out of a billion that these advisors have to care for. And these people, I walk in and they're like, how's it going? How was that test you just took? You know, they know everything about what's going on because we know each other. Like, these are my peers, my friends, my leaders, but also my equals at the same time. And it's one of those incredible things about honors where you need something and they give it to you. I mean, I went through changing my major my sophomore year, and I thought the world was going to fall to pieces. Like, I thought it was the last moment ever. And I walked into Bill's office sobbing, and I was like, please, please, please help me. And he was like, what if we just switch majors? And it was done within 5 seconds, and all of my problems were gone. Just kidding. But it was still fantastically easy, and I would not have been able to do it without the specification of the advising that we receive here. And the coolest thing about these advisors is they don't just do one thing. All of these people are doing millions of things behind the scenes that are making our lives easier, and we don't even know. I mean, just 2 of them right here, Flora and Justin, they run mentoring and the Honors Advisory Board. And on top of taking care of all of us, they're also giving us these other incredible opportunities. Like they talked about, everyone who comes in as a freshman gets their own individualized mentor. And then they have a relationship throughout the first year where you can come to your mentor for advice on classes, on professors, on where to get pizza tonight, like whatever it may be. And then you actually get the opportunity to become a mentor yourself once you've done that for someone else. So I've been a mentor for 3 years now, my sophomore, junior, and senior year, and I absolutely love it. Watching them, like, first years rise up through, like, being worried about starting school to, by the time I'm saying goodbye to them at the end of the year, they're experts. I mean, one of my mentees is right back there, and she has the team together, and I just get so proud every single time. So mentoring is one of those amazing perks of honors where you have something you didn't even know you need, but now that you have it, you can't imagine not having it. And it's similar with advisory board. I mean, I joined that as a sophomore as soon as I possibly could, and throughout that, I've risen from, like, lowly writer for just the basic entry, whatever, to one of the leaders of the committee, and it's an incredible leadership opportunity to be a part of advisory board. The things you can put on your resume, bless you, the things you can learn from your peers, but also from just having to run things. I mean, the individual committees of the advisory board, we have to run events, all of our social media that you see on this QR code and on the form, all of that is run by students. We have to work extremely hard to keep that up. And then we also have a blog where we can write and post and publish our own publications. And that is also run by students, maintained by students. The whole thing is students. And it's incredible. And then I'm spewing, but I think I'll wrap it up just by touching on the thesis experience, because I have officially completed my honors thesis. And I cannot believe I'm saying that, because it feels like just yesterday I was sitting where you were, listening to Bill's speech, saying, hi, Bill, and now all of a sudden it's over. And doing the thesis is incredibly daunting. And that's a fact that I'm not going to try and cover up or sugarcoat. It is hard. It is. But you will get through it with the support of the people in this room and with the support of everyone in the honors community. And truly, I would not have been able to make it through my honors thesis, and I certainly would not be able to stand here and say before you that I'm presenting my research at 3 different conferences this year. But thank you. I would not be able to do that without the support of my advisors, of my peers, of my mentees, of my mentor, everyone around me. And long story short, honors is one of the best decisions I've ever made, and with all of the different plethora of divisions within it, there's something you will find that is for you, and if you can't find it, they'll help you find it. So that is all I have. Anything?
Okay.
Any questions?
So here's, yes.